Good evening there. My name's Lee Ray. I'm going to be a commentator. We've got Andrew Mackay and Christian Phillips in the next match coming up. Like a dry break there from Andrew. Get these scores updated for you throughout the match. So Christian's took control of the game now. He's reds, Andrew's on yellows. Until we get the scoreboard updated, Christian's on reds and Andrew's on yellows. That's a great shot there from Andrew. Took the corner back now. Looks like this frame's going to be a bit of a tactical battle. As all the new viewers that have just joined us, the new camera system that is mounted up over the top of the table. So you can see a bird's eye view of all the balls, some of the camera angles, just gives the viewers at home a much better view of the table. Sometimes can be deceiving. Now we're joined with Dan Davey. How you doing, Dan?
We're in.
Yeah,
we're good, in. Thanks.
That's a really good shot there from Andrew. He's just played the yellow into the middle and sort of quite gently skill-shotted his other yellow onto the red, so... giving himself a chance to win the frame. he's looking at trying to. He wants a ball to basically play the plant hard enough so that the yellow he plants onto the red and yellow comes back out.
Yeah.
So he just needs to. You just want to be right behind it when you play that shot, so that you can make sure you're accurate enough to only hit it half ball, so that the yellow comes back out. But it's going to go towards the black. Bit of luck required, but obviously if you judge the pace right, it should leave yourself a shot.
Do you think he'll take the plant now, or do you think I'll take the middle?
Don't know. I think he wanted to be a little bit away from the cushion so that he could stun back to play this.
If he takes the plant on now, he's got a reserve ball in this corner.
Yeah, he has. I think what he wanted to do, I think he might be doing that. He might do that now, but what he wanted to do was just be a little bit sort of closer to, say, is it the green spot? Yeah, the green spot, and then be able to play the plant from right behind it, because you.
What kind of angle has he got on this ball?
If he had a bit more angle, he might have been thinking of. I don't know if he still can, but just put the yellow bottom right and rest onto the red and yellow. Leave the white where it is. Hope not to leave yourself Chinese snookered. Sort of what he's done.
That's come out good.
Yeah, that's a good shot. Bit risky, but he had no choice. He cued it well.
That's right. Great shot. Andrew,
first frame
on the board. Christine Phillips to break now.
Really good shot here. See that he actually just flicks the first red, but that then kisses it back down. So there's a bit of fortune, but he deserved his luck because it was a good shot. He had to really force that angle. I think he cheeked the pocket as well. It was a much, much better shot than it probably even looked.
That's right.
I think I've played him a couple of times. He's quite underrated, I think.
Yeah, he
really, you know.
Doesn't get the publicity, does he? But he's certainly capable.
Yeah.
That's quite a really nice good break. That's a lovely break, yeah.
The sound it made.
It's the first opening ball I might have to play the plant.
Yeah, wants yellows. But I don't know if the yellow nearest to the middle goes into this corner. I don't think it does. Might play the plant. If he's right behind it, it's not that difficult a shot. Yeah, that's a good shot.
He's a very good potter, Christian, isn't he? He doesn't miss money.
No.
He thumps them in, doesn't he?
Yeah, very aggressive as well. He's a good good player to watch. It's just come out enough. Oh, just drift back in at the end.
Just fell back in here.
Yeah, I don't know if he's right behind it, if he can just trickle it in. Otherwise, he's got himself a problem ball.
I wonder if he could pinch the corner pocket at the top and screw into it a little bit.
I don't know if he's on it now, is he? Can he see the one in the corner now? He's having a good old think about it, so it's obviously not. I think he's looking at the one here, bottom right maybe. It's quite unfortunate, really. I suppose he, in theory, should have hit it a fraction harder, but he seemed to play the shot well. It's just he's following through. I think he thinks it goes. You don't know really unless you're Christian. Obviously you can just play it into the corner, but if it does go in the middle, you want to play it in the middle really. It's just what route he's going to take the balls, because he can't get very close to it from this ball on the top right corner. And you'd ideally want to go top right, right middle, left middle, and then yellow and black at the bottom of the table, but I don't think you can do that. That says to me you can definitely pot this in the middle.
They always land hampered them, don't they?
Yeah. Yeah, he's a horrible shot. No.
No.
It was obviously as tight as it looked.
Goes down as a missed pot there for Christian Fowler. Stats.
These are the chances you really want to take when you're 1-0 up and your opponent's made a mistake. You've just done a good finish to get the first frame. He's probably feeling quite good about himself. He's, you know, he feels settled probably.
Relaxes your nerves a little bit, doesn't it?
Yeah, you just want to punish these mistakes early doors if you can. There's a good shot to hold it. They're not gimmies queuing off the cushion. You should finish these. You just need one careful positional shot coming down table, and then should be frame over. This is the key shot. It's got quite a big margin, but this is pretty much the only thing that can go wrong now. It's all about the pace.
He's able to hit that a bit.
Yeah, did he? I think maybe he would have come down towards the pink spot more and then gone left middle and then took these bottom two. But he's okay. This is missable. I think, yeah, but the previous shot, he just wanted to, if he could have come down the table in a straight line towards the pink spot and then dropped the red into the left middle, he could have took the two, he'd have been perfect on these bottom two.
Yeah.
I don't know if that's what he tried.
It's a three on the pot, should be a natural angle to run through the middle.
Yeah, big shot. Yeah, not easy.
Bit of nerves to start off with, I think.
Yeah.
Let's get settled. Confidence booster now goes to Christian, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Gets him back at the table, gets his arm in.
Yeah, you feel so much better at 1-1 if you're Christian than if you're Andrew. Each.
So Dan, how have you been playing lately? Have you got your game tonight, tomorrow?
I had a bye in the pro, so yeah, on again Sunday, and first match is 11:30 tomorrow, so
a bit of a lion for you.
Yeah, I hate getting up in the mornings, whether it's for work.
The Sunday 9 o'clock.
I just hate getting up in the morning. Terrible. Too lazy. Snooze. I must snooze about. I snooze at least 5 times a day. I do. I have 5-minute snooze on my phone, and I deliberately do it as well now. So I think, well, I need to be up by 8, so I can't set my alarm for 8 because I need to snooze it a few times. So I actually set my alarm for about 20 to 8. So that I snooze it a few, and then you gradually wake up. Then you need to be settled before you. Big 9-ball, fat tip on that.
That was a big tip.
It was a big tip.
Always been kicked enough there.
It was a good break though, but what a swing!
What does that go down there? Dan, does it go down as a?
We go an unforced error?
Yeah, I think it's caused
an unforced error. We'll go unforced error.
Andrew.
I think the white was going over towards that corner anyway, wasn't it?
Yeah, it bounced off the cushion and got kicked back in by the red.
Yeah. No one wants to send the white over there, do they? They want to hold the white in the middle of the table, really.
Are you a cup break kind of guy, or are you a front man, or...?
No, I'm a break terribly when it matters most guy. But And so many people tell me, oh, you've got a really good break. Yeah, you're a really good break. Yeah, not when it matters. Give me the money game, I'll break like a break terribly. but there's no excuse either, because I've said before, the break's a skill. Obviously, there's a big luck factor in it, but if I had a money game recently, lost it, missed a few crucial ones, but I did break really badly. And that breaking really badly isn't me saying I had lots of bad luck off the break. That's me not cueing it.
Yeah.
The break's a proper shot. It's not a smash. It's not a whack. You know, it's a proper shot. And
a miss there from Christian.
Yeah, I don't know if he just only had maybe like three quarters of a pocket there, but that's a. Although he's still probably big favourite in this frame, looking at where these yellows are. But yeah, that it was disappointed though, because I think maybe he just had only three quarters of a bag for that.
Has Andrew got the back double on this yellow, do you think? Has a chance to get his ball out
and cover the bag if he misses it.
Cover the bag if it misses, yeah.
Yeah.
The attacking player would play that, because Christian balls are quite in a good position there. He needs to do something.
Well, that's the point. What else can you do?
Maybe just play the plant in the top bag, leave himself a double to come down. But
that's very attacking. That's creative.
I'm very attacking.
I know you are. You won earlier today, didn't you?
Yeah, I've just played my game. Yeah, I won 8-4 against Miles Deleuze.
What was the match like?
It was okay. I got off to a good start, 4-1. I had one of them breaks where I smashed it and they all landed absolutely gorgeous.
Really?
And it took me about 25 seconds to bot them all.
To win the match?
No, that was early doors. I think I went 4-1 up by that point, but I felt quite comfortable then. I started.
Settled you in?
Yeah, it settled me right in. I think Miles had a few breaks where they kind of went a bit scruffy. He tried to do his best, but some arms don't go well there.
There's a lot to be said for that, but you you can have matches sometimes where you, although you both may pot off the break five times each with a couple of dry ones each, you definitely do have matches sometimes where they all seem to land nice for you and awkward for your opponent, or the other way round. There's a lot to be said for that, and I cleared off the break three or four times. Well, yeah, but you had three or four really easy layouts from the break. There's other times where you'll clear once off the break and you've almost played better.
Yeah.
So there's a lot of just playing your shot.
It's worked out okay.
He's got away with that.
Would that go down as
a missed pot?
It's a missed pot, yeah.
Christian's just going to try and leave him on the side cushion here. There's not really a lot else he can do. See, I think Andrew can pot this yellow top right. I think there's something in. Don't like saying this, but cutting the yellow into the top right corner with a trace of left and going into your yellow on the bottom left hand side of this table with a bit of pace and just sort of seeing what happens.
Yeah. He's in the situation where he has to do something, because
you're so far behind in the frame. Sometimes you need to trust the luck a little bit.
Christian's obviously got the opportunity to play the three ball plant in the bottom right corner.
Yeah.
And, you know, the chances are they're going to come out okay, so I'm just to try and do something here. I think you're right there, Dan. I think that is probably the best chance he's got.
Because he can't put it in hold to play the. He's played it, but. Obviously, ideally, you'd like an angle on this one over the right middle to come down and play the skill shot, but I don't know if it's don't know if he's got the right angle or not. Just covering the bag. This is where it drops in. Sod's law.
That's a good shot, yes.
Yeah, don't get me wrong, if you're right behind it, that's quite an easy skill shot, but he's got himself back in the frame
Christian could maybe play the attempted double at the top. Oh, he's gone for
the... Yeah, I think he's just flicking out off the side of it.
I would have been more inclined to flick this one.
The ready was closest to you.
Yeah, potentially play the double. If it went in, you've got the 3-3 ball plant, isn't it? It gives now Andrew an opportunity to get his yellow out.
Yeah, if you could...
I wonder if he's got an angle to cut this corner left bag really, really thin and send the white back across. Attacking again.
He's attacking. The other side, from I like to be attacking as well, but if you do just rest the yellow bottom right corner, if you do just roll into that and rest it over the top of the red, you're even more in the frame. You know, you're properly in the frame then, because not only has Christian got to play some sort of billiard shot to get that out, he's also then got to play a skill shot as well, and you just...
Would he not then just back double this red?
Well, he could, but then you're running the risk of leaving the yellow over the bag. So you can back double this red now, but unless that comes out perfect, the yellow's going to stay down in this area. And it just... From 5 minutes ago, Andrew was in a bad way, and he's looking all right now.
Certainly pulled it back, actually.
Yeah, it's a sort of 50-50 frame now, really. Oh, I think he wanted that in, because he was going to play the double, but at pace, and he could have guaranteed himself onto the red into the left middle. You'd still rather be Christian, wouldn't you?
Yes. Yeah, he's Christian now with that middle bag.
What do you who do you practice with? What's your preparation been like for this tour, for example?
In the northeast where I'm from, Hartlepool Way, Ryan Clark.
He's
ex-snooker player.
Yeah.
We've got quite a few players, actually. There's a lad on the tour called Nicky Eller. He came over this year and he started an amateur.
Yeah.
And another lad called Craig Brown.
Okay.
They're both from a snooker kind of background. Craig's had a few 145 breaks, type thing. So
really?
They're certainly capable.
Yeah.
And I think Nicky came from more than 9-ball tour years ago.
Okay.
They're both very, very different players, different styles. But they're both very, very capable. How about yourself? Have you got like a practice partner?
No, we used to have a club in Reading which is shut last July, so I've played a hell of a lot less this year. My nearest club now, a bit spoilt really, because it used to be 5 minutes drive from my house. My nearest club now, there's two. There's Racks in Maidenhead and the Crucible in Newbury, which are both with zero traffic. They're both half an hour each way, and it kind of, I always intend to practice more than I do, so this year I've been very unprepared at pretty much every tour. So
have they got the blue similes cloths on?
Only the one in Newbury has. Mm-hmm. They've got two.
How do you find it, Dan?
Yeah, I like them. Yeah, I do like them. I think if I had a pool club, I'd have it full of them, because they definitely last better. A worn blue cloth, from what I've seen previously, a worn blue cloth is a lot better than a worn nap cloth. These are similar, aren't they? Whether they are the these cloths 6 months old or 3 months old are a lot better than the your nap cloth. But also, yeah, they do just play. I think they do play better. I don't think it really makes much difference. I think it looks a lot better. That's what I think.
Well, I've noticed sort of a few local clubs is, I think they really need to get the cloth extra tight, like stretched really tight. A few local clubs where they're not so tight, and you know, they feel quite slack on the table, and I think they slope quite a bit.
These cloths or the?
Yeah, the blue ones, yeah.
So that's just the table fit and not done.
Yeah, that's the table off.
Yeah, I think that's one of the main advantages for these.
These are fitted perfect.
I know Carly's new club, Northampton Sports Bar, she sponsors some of the IPA stuff. She's got all blue cloth, and I think they all the longevity's if you own a if you own a pool club, it's probably a no-brainer on that side of things.
If I was Andrew here, I'm afraid I'd have to cut this thin and attack now.
Yeah, you've got
Christian's just trying to play a shot to bring his red back into play, and he's left it a bit safe.
Yeah. Do you go cut thin off of the yellow bottom left?
Yeah.
Or do you... Because I think now he's looking at playing the yellow top right, bringing the white out towards the yellow spot, and then leaving himself... But then I don't like that, because the red's in the way of the plant, so you have to be a little bit more accurate with the plant. I prefer your shot. So you can do this, but if you flick the red, before the plant, then it's probably going to go wrong, because you're going to put the red into the red and yellow, and you need to, you only really want to hit the yellow first.
That's a great shot.
if
that went wrong though, that I suppose he then had that second bite of the cherry. Hopefully, the shot we said earlier.
Yeah.
But that came out lovely.
I still prefer
lovely.
Your shot. I think that was more likely to go wrong than to go well, if you know what I mean. But early doors, I think it couldn't have failed if you hit it right.
It's two frames now. Andrew's played a
pulled a good finish. Yeah.
Yeah. Crucial shot out.
Did you play this one first? Fair enough. I see. Venue's good.
Absolutely.
In here, isn't it?
It's, very good venue.
A lot of space, aircon. This hotel is owned by the same people as the Bradford Hotel.
Right. Is it the Cedar House, is it?
Yeah, that one. Yeah, I believe. Is it the Bradford Hotel, yeah? Yeah, it's owned by the same people. So.
Oh, right, sorry, yeah.
Oh, right, okay. If it sounds like we're having a conversation with... we've got a third party that only we can hear, which is Dave, the stream guy, as everyone will know him. And, he talks to us, but you can't hear him. And he's just pointed out that it's the Bradford Hotel is the sister hotel to all the part of the same group as this one.
But no, this venue is absolutely great.
Yeah, it's a good one, yeah. And it's literally 5 minutes drive off the junction on the M4. If you were to fly here from... How did you get here?
We came quite sensibly. Now we drove from Teesside.
Yeah.
But we set off at 10 o'clock in the morning.
Okay.
And literally got here by 2:15, 3:15. Hit absolutely zero traffic.
Yeah, no rush hours about then. It's quite a sensible time here, you're right.
That's a big break.
That's a massive break.
Ball potted.
Straight down as well, Christian. It's a really easy layout. You'll just want to come back across roughly where he is now. Don't know if he's got a perfect angle. He might have wanted to have a little bit more angle so he can run in and out the cushion. Just floating across. Stun the white back. Bottom left, bottom right. Two each. I suppose this isn't a complete gimme now that he's queuing awkwardly. I still expect him to get it. Oh, it wobbled, didn't it?
You can just assist at the bottom, I think.
Just the barrel.
Okay, yeah. But yeah, so we arrived about 2:30 yesterday, and all the tables were still getting set up. The room was quite bare, actually.
Yeah.
Poor Louis carrying the tables everywhere and.
He carries them on his own, doesn't he? One under each arm.
Yeah.
Two each.
I like the new camera system that we've got.
How many cameras?
The one that vertical above the top of the table.
5, 6 cameras now?
We've got 2 stream tables now, haven't we?
Oh, we've got 2 stream tables?
Yeah, there's a camera on the right.
I noticed that, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, so you viewers at home can't see that table yet, but we do have 2 stream tables now.
yeah. Set up for. Oh, okay, for the amateur final. Okay, so we're going to.
That's good then. So obviously the professionals take preference over the amateurs, but obviously now the amateurs have their own table for the final. That's a really good thing. I definitely agree with that.
Especially the standard of the tour. I mean, there's a good 15, 20 amateurs that you wouldn't be surprised to see in the final of a tour. The standard this year is higher than it's ever been on the amateur side of things.
Mm.
Definitely.
Oh, definitely.
That's a nasty little break. I think, yeah. Andrew just looking to see if the red goes. I think he's very close to touching the yellow. Let's see if that goes into the middle.
Could potentially take the top right corner, take yellows, and try and take control, because the reds seem very.
It's a good point, yeah.
Tough.
It's a good point, yeah. Just drop the yellow in top right corner. Maybe cover the bag at the top of the table and leave the white where the yellow is on the top cushion. No, he's gone attacking. Yeah, the red goes. So
that's fair.
Good shot, yeah. He's done really well to hold it, actually. Really had to play that dead weight. And if he can just miss, if he can just slide past the yellow and red that are together, he may be able to get this. Maybe able to get the red out that's the only red that doesn't go, basically. He'd love to come from behind and just bump it out a tiny bit, but I don't think he's got the angle to do that. So he's got to trust a bit of luck. He hasn't got it. If that yellow would have just stayed away from the jaw, it hit the jaw and came back in and covered the bag.
Yeah.
That was always the danger.
He's got a little bit of work to do now, Andrew.
Yeah.
How did you get here then, Dan? Did you fly, drive?
I live 35 miles away.
Sick.
Yeah.
Sick.
Yeah, it took me about an hour, because I had a half day at work, so I intended to.
You could have run that, Dan.
Yeah, I couldn't have. I couldn't have walked it. These days. I had a half day at work, so I intended to get here for about. I thought I'd get here before rush hour. I'll make sure I'm here by about half three. I leave half two at the latest. I finish work at one. Went for lunch with my mate from work, who was also on a half day. He goes on holiday tomorrow. I just want to pop in, get myself some shorts and some from the shops. Yeah, no worries. 4 o'clock, we finished.
Hmm?
Honestly, the stereotype of a woman being the nightmare shopper, he's way worse. Dave Shaw. Nightmare.
Mention out to Dave Shaw.
Oh, my God. Just. Anyway. Still cling up. Can he back double this now? Oh no, I don't think.
Oh yeah, I think he
back
yeah,
double
can,
it into
yeah.
a big bag.
There is a gap,
but it's getting harder though, because
the weight's gone.
The
weight's
going all over the place, and although it's coming, I think the natural angle will be coming back down towards this red and yellow. But
he's going for the treble.
No. Oh, can he double it? No, he's playing the double. Just missed it, and
didn't quite think it was on there, to be honest.
Yeah, it was. I think screwing it didn't help, because it straightened it up as well.
That was just all from the break, really.
It was tough from the start, yeah.
From the break.
You expect to see Christian go 3-2 up here. He just needs to make sure he does the right thing with his. With his first shot, I see he's just figuring out what to do, or what the right thing is to do.
What's your views on these kind of shots, Dan? Do you like to put a ball safe, or do you sometimes just commit yourself to your own colour?
If you've got five gimmies, you may as well put a ball safe. But, yeah, I wouldn't want to compromise.
An easy dish.
Yeah, so if you've got a tricky area or one tricky ball, the priority should be to make sure that after your free shot, you finish the frame. you shouldn't be trying to put another ball safe.
Run out of position a little bit there. That's Crystal.
Yeah, that's a bad shot. That's really not good at all. He's just just the lapse of concentration. That's not.
He may be able to see enough of the top.
I think the shot's the double. He's playing. He's dropping it in the middle. Missed it. This would be a real steal for Andrew now. I know he got in first, but the clearance was always difficult. But now Christian's had an easy chance to win this frame. This would be a real killer for Christian if Andrew knocks this long, because these are tough shots. Queuing off the cushion, pretty much straight as well. Length for the table. Really good queuing, just drop it in, just full-blooded.
Dead weight kind of shot, isn't it?
Yeah, I suppose dead weight, yeah, because then if you do cover the bag, you've still got a chance in the frame, actually. So it might be able to psychologically take a little bit of pressure off the pot if... Here we go. Oh, he's back up. What's up with Andrew? Is he asking people to sit still? Is he? Ask the ref to come round. He might have asked the ref to come round to clean the cue ball. I don't know what. The ref's coming. From a distance, you don't know whether it's Mel or Scott. But it's Scott McMillan.
All will be revealed.
Oh. Yeah.
My ball's getting clean now.
Ball's getting clean. Oh, he's dropped.
Maybe an unforced error from Scott.
That is an unforced error, yeah. He's dropped his buck. If you could just push it a little bit further away from the cushion, please.
Yeah.
Is it lovely? I suppose if you can only see a fraction of the cue ball and it's got a bit of fluff or dust on it, it probably can get in your eye line.
Let's see if it's made any difference.
Straight down. He's played the snooker.
That's not London too bad.
He's fantastic. He's played the snooker.
Shot Andrew. Nice shoot that.
Oh, that's a beauty.
See, I don't play them safety shots pretty often.
He says a shot to nothing, you know, try and cover the bag. Scott's Andrew's apologised, put his own that thing. When you're playing them dead weight, it's so much easier to miss them by a mile than, you know, queuing right off the cushion. It was obviously in his head as well, otherwise he wouldn't have got the ref over to, you know, to clean the cue ball. I think Christian can just about see the cut, so I think he's actually
it does go past.
Has he got a big bag?
He's got a bag.
Oh, yes, yeah, no, he didn't have a big one. Oh, no, the white. Did that flick off the black as well? If it did, that was unlucky. I didn't see whether it...
No, I don't think it flicked off the black. It
just went straight in.
Went straight in, yeah.
That's a bit harsh, because you couldn't really... It's hard to control the white there from queuing right off of that cushion.
Great chance now for Andrew to go three.
You just need to get down, knock him in, Andrew. Don't think about these.
Yeah, that's right.
You can create problems that aren't there.
This is the question I was asking earlier. Would you concentrate now on just potting your ball, or would you play extra to put his ball safe. I'll go and attack my own ball because I've done it before.
Always attack your own ball, yeah, definitely. No, actually, I suppose actually you could just, yeah, you can't fail. He just pushes the yellow down the cushion. Doesn't matter if it goes over the bag or not. Mm-hmm. And now you have got three
stun shots.
So
drop in now. No danger now for Andrew McKay. McKay?
That's got to be McKay, isn't it?
McKay
would be K-A-Y, I guess. McKay. I don't really know. McKay.
Yep, good shot.
Oh, he's up again. Down, down.
3-2. Solid, 3-2. See if we can have a few breaking dishes now on the stream table for the viewers at home.
They're certainly breaking well enough. These two, they're really... I know it's... it is easier to break well on a very good, quick table. I think the lights help.
I like the overhead view when it's the break off.
On the break, yeah. Good
view. Bang!
Look at it go. Massive breaks.
He's dry.
He's not got a ball.
He's come up dry.
It's criminal. Trying to force that a bit, took his eye off the pot. I mean, it wasn't a gimme, but it was an easy enough shot. He's just trying to get the white back out.
He's forcing Christian to take a red now, though.
Yeah. I think he has to get into his little problem area early. He can do it straight away. He can stun the white here, and now he's got the angle to go straight into it. I think it's quite hard. I think you got hit with a decent amount of pace, didn't you?
Oh, you spin it in the top bag.
Ah, so the okay. Saxons. Yeah, the red goes, that's a great shot, because the red goes, oh, it must go top left, I guess. Otherwise, oh, no, he's
still got a
just
shot.
Just about okay. He'd love to have been an inch further back, though, and then he could have just rested into the black. Red top right and then come down for the two at the bottom of the table.
He's going to take it into the top bag, but the white's running into black. You never know where the black can go, and it's obviously sacrificing his position, so he needs a little bit of fortune. Yeah.
It's a good clean shot.
Yeah,
it's just
hard, but he's not quite on any balls now.
No, he's sort of half snookered on two of them, and yeah, he's just all that. Just he played such a good shot to land on the one down the rail into this bottom right, and then just kind of gave the initiative away from the next shot. Just overhit it slightly. I think that's a good shot. If Andrew can't see the potting angle of this yellow, I mean, even if he can, it's not an easy shot.
Yeah.
I think he'll be playing safer, though. I don't think Andrew will be attacking from there. There's quite a decent area in this at the very bottom of the table. But yeah, he's just jacking up now where he can lead the white to put Christian in a bit of trouble. But he just flick maybe half ball off the black with this yellow and leave the white on the back cushion. Just don't want to put any of your balls safe when you play these shots. Happens too often. Yeah, the white's just about made it to the back cushion. Christian in a bit of trouble now, really. I think he's probably going to try and get the white back behind his red, but that's not not easy. Needs to run. That is a really, really good shot.
He's cleared that absolutely perfect.
Really good shot. Touch.
That's a really good shot. Now, any hit on any ball from Andrew, which the chances are is going to happen, he could leave Christian the finish.
I think if he can rest, on this...
Do you think the ball near the pink?
Yeah, just above the spot. Or even just the one just below the spot. As long as the white rolls forward a little bit, he's going to be... It's a total snooker, which helps.
Yeah, he's going to try and get the one closer to the pink.
Yeah.
His chances are he's going to leave.
See that? Yeah, he needed the white to carry on after that. I think he was playing your shot. I think he was playing the one above. Because if you left the white where that is, then Christian's only got a really thin cut. But as it is now, he's got himself a chance.
Black ball.
Used to manoeuvre the white well. I think I think he's all right. Just about.
I think he might have opened this place for the middle.
Oh.
Black to go in the middle now. That would be nice for Christian.
Just about okay, I think. Looking at his face as he walked round, he seemed to be... He's just about got enough angle to punch it over. Maybe cheek the pocket a little bit. Just stun over to this left-hand cushion. Oh, I think he can barely pot it. So he's had to just drag it in and leave himself a difficult shot. He's got cue this well.
This is a really big shot.
Yeah, has to get the white over into this bottom right hand corner of the table. Doesn't want to go near the pocket either. I think the natural angle might be, he's playing it with a tracer side, which makes the pot harder. It's a great shot. Really good shot. Should be three each, yeah?
Three all.
Snooker's won in that frame. Really, really good shot from Christian. He was in a bit of trouble there. Taking a little tactical... he's going for a break. He's doing the old tactical toilet break. Look at the shoes on him.
Brand new shoes.
Oh, if we can get them shoes on camera. They're good as well.
Have you seen Mel Harley's shiny shoes?
And his shiny head. You got shiny shoes? It's me talking, yeah. Yeah, no hair. Danny, no hair. There's a lot of bald heads around this table. You look around, there's... must be a trait of ball players. Must be something in the air that makes you lose your hair. Oh, we're at 3-3 now?
We are at 3-3, yes.
They both missed a couple each, didn't they? Just to... It could easily be 4-2-5-1 either way.
Mm-hmm. From the break, the balls have been open nice, but we've had no breaking dishes yet.
No.
As you can see on the stats on the screen now, Christian's had two dry breaks. And he's had a few enforced error and a few more missed pots.
Yeah, say for example that last frame, Andrew's shot isn't going to go down as an unforced error. He was snookered, but you know, that was a good shot. That's what you don't see on those stats, I suppose, was the good shot from a frame winning shot from Christian.
Yeah.
Which has forced the error. Andrew's just come over and asked how many thousands are watching. Tell me about 20,000. Just watching you, Andrew.
Both players still look a little bit cagey to start with, though, and they have not. No one's actually.
Yeah.
Haven't gotten a bit of a rhythm yet.
No one's hit top gear.
No.
Have they?
No.
They're not.
It's just still early doors in the game, but somebody needs to take off.
Yeah, they both almost. They haven't. Either one of them could have been 5-1 up if they'd have been at their sort of at their best. And yeah, they just haven't kicked on yet, have they, really?
So Andrew to break now.
It's some hammer break so far. Let's see if that carries
on. Bird's eye view of the break. This is that big tip.
Yeah, the big 9-ball cue. Oh, he caught him well, but that's an unforced error for me, straight in the middle. That's not a great shot.
Yeah. Fancy there, Dan. You fancy yellows?
This is where you need to take your extra 30 seconds. Just study the table, and sometimes you look at it and you think, oh, "What are we going to do here?" And all of a sudden, it comes to you. You think, "Well, actually, there's one shot that can open the frame up."
He's going to flick off this, and he's going to open his other one near the red.
There you go.
And he's going to go yellows. Nice.
I'm not sure what he's done there. Yeah, I didn't like that shot. I think he was trying to flick it to the red and yellow, wasn't he?
I wonder if the yellow that's sat next to the red, near this the white, passes in the middle with the big bag, potentially.
I suppose, so actually, because if it does, then he's already got a route for the finish, although he'll need to be very close to his cue ball control when he gets to the final yellow and black next to each other. That may have been the balls that I disturbed to start with, but he kind of made his mind up fairly quickly, didn't he?
He did, yeah.
He's doing trust a bit of luck here. He'd love to hit it half ball on the left hand bottom side of the yellow. This is a bit more full, the yellow sort of stuck to the side cushion, but there's only really one good pot away from winning this frame. If this yellow does go into the bottom, to the right middle, then he just needs to. This is effectively frame ball if he can land perfect on it. It's a great shot, he's queued that really well. I want it to be a little bit further over. If he was 6 inches over to the right, he could have just dropped this in the right middle, dropped the one top right corner, and then screwed across for the black. But now he's running sort of into the red, possibly flicking off it, going behind it.
The danger when he plays the middle now, if he actually flicks the yellow over the bag,
yeah,
could put some more ball safe.
Which he has, and
yeah, it's right. It.
Yep, called it. Having a look now to see if this yellow will go off the red that's just covered his that covers his yellow. I don't think it does.
I think maybe the shot now is to just try and
cover that bag. Just hopefully you
get a shot. The 3-bar plant bus.
Say in golf, don't they? Just take your medicine. Don't try and play a hero shot and guarantee losing the frame. If you can cover the bag, then you've still got a foothold in the frame, but. You see a lot of people just lose the rag after, you know, try and play a hero shot. We thought we could.
So he tried to punch it in off the red.
Yeah, he thought
don't
he could.
Don't think he could quite see.
I don't know. I think
he'd be a bit thicker than that.
I think he hit it as thick as he could. Probably.
I don't think he could have hit it any thicker, yeah.
So I don't know if...
Is that plant now there for Andrew on that red?
If the plant goes, it's a bit easier, but he has got the angle to go straight into it. The only thing that makes it difficult is he's bridging over the yellow, which makes this missable. But he's almost guaranteed to be on a red once he goes into these two. So it really is just a case of stunning this red in, and he's really having a hard look to see whether that plant goes, because he'd love to just be able to concentrate on the pot and just screw him back. He doesn't really want to play the stun if he doesn't have to, but either way, he should be fine. I think the red's far enough off the cushion to make it a fairly easy shot. I think this one's a bit more personal preference. There's some people that really, really hate bridging. If you don't mind bridging, you'd be down and knocking. You'd knock this in by now, because it's not that hard a shot. He's quite close to that yellow.
He's playing the plant now.
His cue's very close to that yellow.
He pushed it over.
He's played them. If they were touching, he's reversed.
Yeah, he's pushed it the wrong direction.
The wrong way, yeah. For those that have never done it before, if you have a dead set plant and they're touching ball, the second ball actually goes the opposite of where it would, the way that it would normally go when you play a plant. They call it a reverse plant, because it actually sort of slides and skids. I think Andrew's just hit the wrong side of it there. Either that, or we just thought it went quite comfortably, so it didn't matter.
That plant then, would it go down as a missed par or unforced error?
Oh. it's got to be a missed par, because he went for a pot, didn't he? Unforced error, I suppose, would be running out of position. I guess. Trying to snooker and not getting the snooker, I suppose.
I predict a brick and dish.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Alright.
Let's do this.
He's going to get four off the break. There you go. Kiss of death. One.
We both kissed the death bat, didn't we?
He's going to do well to clear these. Now, they all actually go. He doesn't really need to dislodge anything, but getting on his ball at the top of the table is going to be his biggest problem. Getting good position on the yellow next to the red over on the by the left middle is his second biggest problem. Maybe take this into the bottom right. If he can bring the white over past the halfway line, if you imagine a line down the middle of the table, so get to the right of the pink spot, to the right of the pink and black spot, and then you could leave yourself an angle to go up table through the gap and land on the yellow on the top cushion, and then you're going to need a good positional shot to get in the gap to leave your yellow bottom left. I think that probably is... probably his route. It's not easy though.
I need to flick a left hand side on this.
Okay, I think he's perfect to play this yellow top left corner now and go between the red and black. Land on his bad ball in the top cushion. I don't know if this was the route that he wanted at the start of the finish. No. Okay. It's getting more difficult. So he can maybe really dig into the cue ball. I think he wanted to be closer to this yellow though. If he's closer to the yellow, it's a much easier shot, but I don't think he can get into it enough. That's why he's looking at playing off the playing half ball off the red to get close to the yellow. If he was just a couple of ball rolls over to the right hand side, he could have dug in and got position. He sort of played it well, but it was always tough. Really tough chasing that finish, but there wasn't really any obvious safety shot to take control of the frame. That's kind of had no choice but to go for, I suppose.
Chance now for Andrew.
Yep.
See what he's got. With Christian having the ball tied on the back cushion, it gives him a bit of a breathing.
Yeah, I think
when he takes the plant down the corner.
Do you think he'll take the plant, or do you think he'll try and leave himself an angle off of this shot?
Pot this, then I'd take the plant.
Would you? So I think I'd try and. I'd ideally want an angle to go into it now, I think. Depends how easy this plant is, I suppose. So if you go into this at the right pace and hit the gap between the two reds, it can't go wrong. But I think you're right. If the plant was slightly more on, I think that's what I'd do. But what's he going to do here then?
Yes, that's come out absolutely great.
It's come out
good.
Good
shot, Andrew. Very good shot.
Yeah. You have to trust a little bit to that, didn't you? I think you either play that really softly or like Andrew's done, play it really hard and make sure that you get that ball away from that corner area where the yellow is. Yeah, good shot. Should be four each.
Yeah.
Well, if you just come a little bit straight. Like to be a tight fraction further up.
I think the red passes the bottom right corner, so he could top it through a bit and play it that way.
Yeah, I think that's what he's played, yeah.
One good putt, Andrew.
One good putt, yeah. I don't know if these are the ones you want to be right behind it if you've only got. You obviously want to be right behind it anyway, but you know, when you've only got 80% of a pocket. It just can be really off, be a little bit off putting. You're a little bit more important to be right behind it.
Nothing to do with the white.
Did he get kick? He's missed it by a fair bit. Can he wedge this in between? I don't know. I think it's maybe a bit close. He's looking at it. Oh no, he's playing it.
Bit of double.
He's straight down.
Big back double. No.
Right.
Well, just left Andrew the cut.
He's decided very quickly there.
Yeah.
Didn't he?
It's a big shot for a quick shot.
Big shot, yeah. I think if you're Ryan, a coach, man, you'd probably tell him to take his time a little bit more. 5-3 or 4-all is big, isn't it? Especially when your opponent's had a chance to win the frame.
All in on this cut, I'm afraid. It's got to go close towards the corner bag.
Yeah, you're going to be really unlucky not to be on the red.
Flick of right hand side, maybe to try and keep it in.
I think you're right, all it. Just make sure of the pot. Because you can only land behind the black or down at the very bottom of the table. Apart from that, you're different. Really? Maybe it was thicker than it looked. I thought he was hitting that so thin. I think Andrew thought the same. That
I think he hit it a little bit too thick.
These can go wrong.
These can go definitely wrong.
That's where you need your extra. Just take your time.
Shot.
I wouldn't have played that shot.
But would you play the pot in the middle, or would you tuck up behind this yellow now?
No, play the pot.
You play the pot?
Yeah, I don't like giving opponent a chance to fluke it.
I totally agree, but that kind of shot there, that for me was the right shot.
Yeah, but he should never have.
No.
And it wasn't that he actually did what he did wrong. I thought when he had the two shots, bring the white over to the top right hand corner of the table.
Yeah.
and then you can come half ball off of the yellow that's on the back cushion. The white will be nowhere near the corner or middle pocket. Swing off two towards the blue spot, and then you've got a big bag into this right middle, into the right bottom right corner, and the other yellow should be up towards the top right corner somewhere. But he just didn't really give it much thought. Going to do well to get the white save after hitting this.
I fancy Andrew to hit this ball, but it will take an element of luck to go in.
Yeah, I think it is quite firm, not an absolute lash, but you've got to hit it hard, give it a chance to go into a few pockets. He's revving up.
Good hit. Where's the white going?
Oh, so you'd probably take that.
Yeah,
I mean,
made things a little bit awkward for Christine now.
Especially if you're queuing right over the knuckle. The ridge of the rim of the pocket. Yeah, see that? Oh, I think he's okay.
Yeah, he's okay.
Just about okay.
That's a big frame for Christine now to go 5-3 up.
Big, yeah, very big.
Andrew doesn't want to let him go any further ahead.
So he's now the chance. Now's his chance to kick on. He just won a real crucial frame like that, and he won one of those just to go 3-0 before he went to the toilet. And he really wants this next frame now, because this will really sort of stick the nail in the coffin, I think, for to go 6-3 from 3-2 down. And I think Andrew had a chance to go 4-2 as well.
I know we were talking earlier, Dan, about the Josh Durant game. He went, was it 7-2 up he went?
Oh,
and
yeah.
He had a yellow and a black, which, you know, for Josh's standard, he didn't seem like too much of a problem. And from that, he got beat 8-7, didn't he?
It's mad, isn't it?
You can't predict these games sometimes.
I've seen it happen far too often, though, when on good tables, when you've got really good playing conditions like this, it's not that unlikely to have...
So a dry break?
Yeah, dry break. Andrew. It's not that unlikely to have two dry breaks. You know, your opponent clears those two. They put off their break, get a couple of easy finishes themselves.
Yeah.
It's not... You know, you can see turnarounds.
Three frames, you can reel three off, you know, quite simply, can't you? Just by...
Yeah. Christian's gone really attacking there as well. Again, he's got straight down he doesn't want to be. I think he's okay. But really good shot first up. Played the double. I mean, didn't really have an awful lot else on, but I think he's attacking. I think what we said earlier. Not trying to criticise Christian. I'm just trying to.
This part.
Obviously, we're just commentating, but he hasn't. I mean, Christian's been in, I think, a couple of pro finals. He's a real top player, European champion. I think he beat Mark Allen in the final a couple of years ago. He's a real top player. He's beat all the top players himself. And I think I've done it myself before. When you don't start a match well, you sometimes try and quicken up.
Yeah.
Just to try and find some rhythm.
You try and find that zone, don't you? You try and find a bit of...
Yeah, the happy medium between taking your time but not getting yourself bogged down. And I've probably one of my weaknesses definitely is sometimes not knowing, not getting the balance right between taking care over your clearance and taking too long and not playing with a rhythm.
That's right, yeah.
I've personally find that one of the hardest things to do is to get that balance right.
What I've noticed on the situation is when you're practicing in your local club here and you're queuing well and you're playing well, you find yourself, you speed up a bit, you run around the table fast.
Yeah, it all comes so easy.
And then when you come to these competitions, I think people have too much emphasis on trying to make sure too much, and they take that extra bit of time, but what that doesn't turn it, it slows their natural game down.
Yeah.
So I think Christian, for me, is a relatively fast player.
Yeah.
And I think that's what he's trying to do. He's trying to get some kind of rhythm going quite quickly, but he seems to be struggling just a little bit.
I say this far too often, but it's another big frame. 6-3 and 5-4 is anyone's game. 6-3, Andrew's a big underdog. So, I mean, Christian's just had two chances and not gimmies. You know, the cut into the middle that he missed wasn't easy. He was obviously trying to judge a cannon as well at the same time, but it's a real let off. That was the time. That was the time for Christian to kick on and go clear in the match, and it looks like going 5-4 now. Just has to hit this at the right pace. He was worried about getting too close to the yellow, and he's just
needed a bit. Just under 6-8 inches there. He needed.
Yeah.
He's still perfectly capable of knocking this in, just bouncing off the left-hand cushion, finishing anywhere near the D.
Sometimes it's good to run out of position in a big frame. 5-3, you really need this frame. You do run out of position, but then you knock in a shot like this, punch it in, white comes twice across. You know, these gives you a bit of an ego boost, doesn't it?
You just have to push your cue through and trust you got down with your shot right.
Yeah.
Push it through.
Yeah. He's not. No, he's sort of quit on
he's
that. Oh,
it.
My God. No. Oh, dear.
And he's got a shot on a thin cut for this corner left.
Oh. He's apologised. He's not really sorry. Oh. You were right. He didn't really get through it. He didn't play it with any confidence, did he?
No.
I think you're right. You just need to trust yourself. Easier said than done. A lot easier said than done.
I just used to mess around a little thing when I was saying earlier about your speed of play. I was coming to the tour and I was slowing myself down a little bit in my games, which was affecting me.
Okay.
So then I tried to think, okay, I'll try and slow my practice sessions down a bit.
Yep.
Instantly quashed that because that was just not working. So now I'm more of a get down, attack, go for it.
Oh, just a little bit thinner in it. That's 5-4 as it is now. Christian's gonna probably clear these in about 25 seconds tops.
I'm starting to feel a bit for Andrew. He's definitely digging in. It's just not quite getting there, is it?
No, just what seems to be that one shot of frame that just gets away from him.
He had that bit of fortune. He's left himself a shot.
Yeah. I think you're right about the pace of what you... I mean, Christian there, he's now got to top this through. It's not really a problem, but...
That's not it's not very nice.
Towards the corner, is it?
Just drop it.
Don't pot it thick.
It's all right.
So, yeah, I think it's right. I think that's what one of the things that... look at your number one on the tour at the moment, Farnsworth. Another player, consistent winner at the moment, Boyle. Farnsworth and Boyle, they both play, I was saying this to one of my mates, that they both play at the same pace. They both play as in a consistent pace.
Yep.
Don't get me wrong, if there's two balls over the, literally over the pocket, and the black's right over the pocket, they might quicken up a bit, but the tempo they play at. Clint does it as well. They play at the same tempo all the time. And in such a repetitive game, things like that, I think, are maybe underrated as to just how important that is to their success or their consistency.
Yeah.
Because you never see Farnsworth running around the table. You never see Boyle get down and just play a shot very quickly. It just doesn't happen. But a lot of the other players, top players as well, it does happen. It really does.
The conversation's been brought up before, and somebody had said that, like the likes of Mark Farnsworth, he practices exactly the same as he does if he's in the tour. He doesn't slow up or quicken or anything.
When he'll cover a bag, he won't go for silly clearances, he'll do the right...
Yep. Do the right shot, yeah.
I've always said that I don't understand, and one of the reasons why maybe I haven't practiced as much as there's some more important reasons, family and work and stuff, but put a lot of time into practice in the past is because the people that I practice with are much like myself, and you end up just messing about after 5-10 frames, doubling the black, and then I just sort of just said, no, what are we doing? What are we getting out of this?
Yeah, what you do, that's what, yeah.
What am I actually achieving from... See, I think Andrew's lost his patience a little bit in this match at the moment. I think if he doesn't get this frame, it's definitely all over. If he can somehow nick this frame, if Christian can let him back in, you're only one break and finish away from being back to 6-5 and it's game on, but see, Christian's not really... Is he not there? But yeah, I've said that before, so I've started to...
Well done. It's been a pleasure, but I have to get going now. I've got a game now against Gary Clark.
Okay, mate. Good luck.
Yeah. I'll see if I can get somebody over with you, right?
No worries, bud. Not the best from Christian. Just going to sit here and talk to myself. Be an interesting point I did make, and I do believe in it quite strongly. Is as of recently, tried to take practice a bit more seriously. Need to find a way to practice where you don't disrespect the game and just run around knocking balls in, and because you're not recreating a match situation. So otherwise, you can put all the hours in you want, but if they're not quality, you know, quality over quantity. Is the point I'm making anyway? So Andrew really needs his frame. This needs to come out nice for him. It's come out okay. The white should just go under, I think, under the middle peg. Just if he can just roll this in, kind of medium paced. Bring the white back out to the blue spot. I think he's looking now right. He's got the right idea, just needs to make sure the natural angle should come out towards the blue spot, and then this could be the start of his comeback. Just to keep running a little bit more. I don't know if he's quite on it. Want it to really be right in line with your brown, blue, pink, black spot, right on that line. And then he would have been okay. I think he's okay now, but this can go wrong. I think if you mess up from here, it probably is match over. 7-3 down. But like I said, 6-4. Clearance off the break. 6-5. It's back to a coin toss. Big shot. Oh, that's a really good shot. He's played it with a bit of drag. It's just about held it enough, I think. Maybe going up table and back down again, but it's his to lose. Chosen to, I think the sensible option there, just to leave himself a shot, not try to be too clever with his positional shot. Needs this. He's missed it. He's just quit on the shot. The scoreboard pressure's done that. 6-3 up, he never would have missed that. Thank you. Good shot from Christian. His frame's certainly not over. Needs to leave himself the right angle after this shot. It's really important that he's missed it altogether. Oh, he's got away with it as well. I think he snookered him. How's your luck? Looking at the double, so he can get. Is he looking at the treble? If he misses the double thin, he's probably going to get the treble. It's just whether or not he can see enough to be able to actually play that shot. But it's obviously close. We can't see from right behind it, but he's not fully snookered. This back kiss, I think he's perfect. Better shot than it looked. 7-3 now. On the brink. Another big break, but a dry break. Christian back at the table looking up to finish the match now. Andrew looks a bit dejected in his chair. His body language isn't great. Whose is at 7-3 down? Christian's, I think he's got the angle. No, he just wanted a little bit more angle than that, but going ultra aggressive. I think you can afford to at 7-3 up, but you don't want to. You don't want to just chuck frames away just because you are 7-3 up and let your opponent back in. But I think he's doing the right thing. He's going into this problem area basically as early as he could. He's going to be trusting to luck, but he has got one over the middle as long as he can keep the white out in the open, which he has done. That's a bit harsh. Possibly looking at the double. It may go in the middle bag, actually. I think he's come round to look at it. Okay. He hasn't quite come out far enough. He thinks he's going to play the double now. If he can double this, I think he'll be forced into it. You want it to be further over, maybe in line with the blue spot, and then he could have just screwed up table towards the where the D would be. Oh no, he did have enough angle. That's a really good shot. He's under hit it, but if he hits that maybe 6 inches further, he's frame of match over. Played a red off the yellow. knowing Christian, I think he's gonna play the red off the yellow. I think yeah. Balls everywhere. Oh, it wasn't on the black anyway. It was trusting to luck, but it's Andrew. Last chance. Can't afford any more mistakes. Left an edge on this red for Christian, which nowhere near enough to pot it. Oh, I don't know. I don't think he could pot. I think he's hit as much of that as he could, but it's not come out too badly. He's perhaps the snooker is the right thing to do. Screw across table, over on the right hand side cushion. The two yellows that are together. Hit the yellow closest to the right, bottom right corner. Hit that into the cushion and back out and just leave that white glued to the other yellow. And then it should be frame over. I know you're 7-3 down. You just don't want to give the match away. You know, you're only one mistake away from being 7-all, maybe not even that. You've got to cling on. It's fine here, just play the snooker. I don't think he can pot the ball. I think he's got the angle. Not that difficult a hit, but certainly prefer two shots. Christian looking at coming off two cushions, actually making the red into the middle. I suppose because if he comes off one cushion and pots it, there's every chance he's still going to be snooking on the black. But is that the right thing to do? It's the entertaining thing to do. No. You know, nervy little shot this, but if you want to win the match, you've just got to get down and knock it in. You're as well on it as you pretty much could be. Obviously, you'd like to be straight behind it, but you're 7-3 down. I think you've just got to loosen your arm up and give it a go. Good shot. One more good shot. Really need to be pinpoint with your white ball here. That's not. Let's be straight behind it. A little bit to over on the left hand third of the table. Real tough shot now to you just drop it in dead weight. Horrible shot to play. Even then, you're not leaving yourself an easy black. But what else can you do? really good shot. A tricky black. Not expecting to get it. Good finish. Is that the start of the comeback? Couldn't have hit them any better. How has he not got a ball? This is where they can turn. Clears these. 7-5. Break and finish. 7-6. So you need to remain positive. If possible, that's not a great one. Not a great shot first up. Potentially, maybe play the up and down double. No, okay. I think he's got the ump. It's happened to us all. Get behind in a match. Don't play anywhere near as well as you can play and have played, and you do just quicken up and sort of you play with, they call it the loser stroke, where you effectively are. You're quickening up because you don't really believe you're going to win the match anymore. Couldn't have gone any worse. What do you do here? Cushion first. Bring the house down. What was he doing? Oh, you take that. He was in more trouble before that shot than he is after. Christian's just got to be careful here, not to, like I said before, make it easy for Andrew to get back into the match. It's a very easy game to be complacent at, Paul, when you've got a lead, because it all seems so easy when you've got your lead. But I think, you know, a couple of sensible shots like that one, just to contain safety. I think, you know, obviously the red doesn't plant into the bottom right corner, so Andrew's not going to finish from here. Rather than push the boat out and try and finish the match, just need to be sensible, you know, just this. I suppose you'd call it match play, you know, just grinding out the wins, finding a way to win. Some days it comes really easy to you, some days it doesn't. When it's not, you should almost be more grateful for the win than when it comes easy to you. Andrew just looking to see if he can go through that gap. If he can go through the gap, he can get the red away. Might want to ref for this shot. I think the white definitely will go through the gap. We'll certainly know from the way that the yellows move, the direction of which the yellows move, whether he's hit red first, but I don't know if he's going to go for it or not. Christian's lovely shoe, top right corner of the page. Maybe he's got a shoe sponsor. it's going to be the last match of the day. Clever shot. A bit of a do or die situation really for Andrew. It's being forced into going for the finish. Probably the sensible thing from Christian to do. That's, yeah. So I think Christian's going to look to go game here. I'd be playing yellow bottom left, screwing in behind to get the white somewhere similar to where it is now. And then you've got quite a few options. It's not come out great at all, but going to his bad area now, I suppose. Also be careful not to get into it too much because the white may go in off if he screws straight across the table, but I don't know if you can get into it enough from there. It's not the best of shots from Christian. Needed to miss that yellow on the way back out. He's not even going game anymore. Again, probably the right thing to do. Forcing Andrew to go game, but you are giving him a chance. Hasn't got much of one. From the way this table's like, how he's going to finish from here. If anyone's got any ideas, let us know. But Christian just kind of squeezing the knife out of him here. He's going for it. Oh. Come on, entertain us. He just sort of thought about it so long, he didn't really know what he wanted to do. I mean, God knows what I would have done in his situation. Tough one. Christian really needs to finish this now. Just a bit positive. Just take the red over the right corner. Come up table, you're going to leave yourself an eight. You want to leave yourself the angle really off this yellow into the left middle. So I'd come up table now. That's a shocker. Absolute shocker. Try come back up table now and leave yourself. You can leave yourself on the blue spot. You can cut the yellow into the left middle. Maybe a tracer right. You want to go left cushion into the red and yellow thick. Plant them thick, the red's going to come out and they should all be there. You know, ideally wanted to get on it first. You always want to get into your bad balls as early as possible, because then you've got more balls to be on once after you go into your bad area. It's played a good shot there, but it was too thin, so you needed to pot that even thinner into the bag to be able to achieve the angle we wanted to create the angle we needed. We did a highlights reel, I don't think this frame would be in it. It's one of those ugly frames. If Andrew can somehow win it, I mean, Christian's had a good three or four chances himself to finish the match now. Andrew's just got to cling on to the hope that he can somehow grind out this frame, maybe off of an error from Christian. Somehow grind this frame out and you can kick on from there. You know, once when you miss a chance to win the match, which Christian's had a couple now, it can play in your mind, and all of a sudden the momentum swings, the momentum shifts, changes. You see the body language change. At the moment, that they're just sort of both kind of waiting for each other to lose the frame rather than going out and winning the frame themselves. Andrew should never have been back at the table, really. Need to make something happen, I think, when you're the one that's behind. Yeah, that's a good shot. It's as good as he could have played from there, but again, Christian, is he trying to win this frame, or is he trying not to lose it? He can try and cover the bag now, leave the white where that yellow is, and then he really has got the match at his mercy. Yeah, he's more in control now than he was previous to this visit. That's a good shot. It really is. He took his time over it. Don't get me wrong, but he couldn't have played that much better, really. I think Christian's just sort of... I think he's saved by the fact that I'm fairly certain that the red doesn't go into that top left corner. It might do now. Oh, okay. Christian's lost patience. It's like a Western. Oh. So Andrew hasn't got an angle to dislodge his bad red, but it is a plant, but he can't plant it. Can he? Maybe ridiculous shot, but play the red into the bottom right corner. Deep screw. You need the white to hit just below the left middle pocket, across the table, right side cushion, and then back across the table and plant the red. That's about all I can see. Christian's come over. How are you feeling? He hates this game. It's been a pleasure to commentate on. Christian wants me to apologise to everyone that's watching. Win's a win. Sometimes it's easy. Gotta laugh about it. I've been there myself. Sometimes you just sort of scrape through matches. You need to win 6 or 7 matches to win one of these tournaments, and you're not going to have it. You're not going to play great in every single one, rarely. Even your top players, they always have 1 or 2 matches they scrape through. Although maybe don't, you know, don't play at their very best. This is one of them. You just need to get it out of the way, get yourself into the next round, go and have a sleep, come back the next day. Tomorrow's a new day. Oh, he didn't run that in. Oh dear. Oh dear. Thank you. Yeah. Clinging on. You're watching this. Paul's normally a little bit more exciting than this. Don't know what else to say, really. It's, wow. What was he trying? Look at going cushion first. I mean, that, I suppose it does go. Oh, God. Not, need a ref. A close up on this. That is a fantastic shot. But I think it was two shots. We get a replay. We're just going to check a replay now. Just going to get a replay up now. Not sure whether it shaved the knuckle on the way through. I personally don't think it did, but we will see from the replay. Didn't touch. It looks very close, but it didn't touch. That's the end of that. much over. Cheers, guys. I hope you enjoyed that.